Hello, this is Bjørn Olsen from Gotevollen Soap. I will now make a new soap today. And I'm using NG Baby B buttermilk type from Nature's Garden. Today. And I really love the scent in the bottle, so I hope I will love it in my soap too. So in here I got my oils, my clay, my sodium lactate, a little amount of aloe vera powder, and some oatmeal. Here I got my lye solution, I got my fragrance here, and my whipping cream here. The colors are there, and the containers I will have my colors part in. So here we start. I will just stick it on myself. Like so. And since I'm using my small bowl, I got to take my stick blender out of it. In goes my lye. With some silk. And I'm soaping in room temperature today. Because I needed the time to play a little. So here we start too. I don't need to stick on this too much. Just taking to the emulsifying before I add my whipping cream. And in goes that part. Like so. That seems to be quite nice trace I got here now. Trace is for me when all the oils and the cream and lye all have come together, that you don't see a oil pattern on the top, or floating on the top. So you don't need to stick blend too much. And I will pour this out now for my color. So here we start with that part. And I know how much I need in each of my containers here. And I will add my fragrance at the end, after I blend my colors, because that is one thing I have found out is quite good to do. Then you got a quite of time to work and play with your colors and things like that. And I will scrape the rest to this, and I hope I have calculated, have it right in my head how much I need to this. today is a sunny day outside. I've been walking my dog again. It's a lovely day in Sweden. Here I live. I will have the most out, like so. That is all I need that for. And I will clean up a little mess here. I was lucky I didn't get anything up in here. Like so. And now for my color part. I will see who I got most in. I think I begin with my red in this one. This is red mica. I think that is enough for that color. And in here I will take orange mica. I'm looking for a bright orange color here, so I need all of it. Like so. I'm quite happy with how this color become. And in here I will take some green mica color. That seems to be fine. For that color. So now I got green, red and orange. So in here I will have my white titanium dioxide. Now I always stick blend it with a mini blender before I even start with my soap and measure out my oils and soap. So it, I maybe don't need to stick blend it when I have it in my soap. I need a little more, I can tell. I'm aiming for a white color here now. Not a cream color, but a white. I think I got it now. So that was my color part. I will move this here now. And I will take in my fragrance. I will have it like this. So I'm taking in my fragrance first and blend it. A little in that, in that, in that. Like so. And I stir it out. I hope my titanium dioxide, my white part here, could stay this liquid. And no rising or acceleration in this, I can tell. Like so. I will have day two like this. And day two like this. And now I will take out my spatula here. Because I have thought of a pattern I want to do here. But I don't know if I'm able to get it. So now I will pour. Like so. I think this will work quite nice today. And the red is quite nice, the red color. So here we pour again. Like so. And I will take that color there. Like so. And now I will pour again. I will pour this like so. And I will switch side again. And I will pour this up high. Good rest I will save for my top. Now we pour this upon. I've never done this before. I don't know how it will work, but that will time show. And that will I say for my top. I will tap my mold down. And I will use my chopstick. I will just take that in. Like so. Just to try to get a pattern inside it. Like so. And that is all I will use that for so far. I will use it on my top too, I think. Now is the tricky part. I think I go for my red, my green color. I need and I will place it on one side. The top is always a little tricky, I think. Get a fine pattern on the top. That is my green color. And I'm spilling a little today. And now for my orange. I hope I have saved enough of my color. Smell is so good here right now. I really love how it turned out in the, when I hit my soap. Done with that. I can use, no, I'm using this one. It's I think I will turn off my mold around here. these things takes time for me, and I'm sometimes I'm a little quiet when I'm doing soap, and sometimes not. It's not that easy. Like so. My last white color. And it stayed fluid. A lovely fluid. I'll place that right between my two colors there. So that will work for now. And I will tap this down like so. Not anymore. And it this to go back again. Like so. I will just clean up some of my edges here before I'm starting with my pattern on the top. Like so. And I will use my chopstick, just clean a little off it. And I will do a pattern on the top. Like so. That is all I will do on the top of this soap. And some more cleanup. And I will spray it with some rubbing alcohol and take some glitter on it. And that I will do without my gloves. So you know. Like so. And what shall I choose for some glitter today? Some green. On that side. And this is my red. that side. And some gold in the middle. Like so. And that is all I have for now. It's quite liquid yet, so I don't take it up so high. So here is the soap, and I'm wondering how it will turn out, but that will time show when I cut it tomorrow. If you have a question, comment, leave them alone, I will answer you. Bye for now.